Hey everybody, it is the Honey Badger, and as you can see, and like I said in the previous video, the pickup is back from the paint booth. We're getting a few things put onto it now finally, which is great, but before we can do a few more things like putting a windshield in, which is desperately needed to drive it actually, I need to fix the slave cylinder for the clutch. That is what went out on my drive home from the paint booth, and I lost my clutch. It was leaking fluid and didn't have enough to create enough pressure to disengage the clutch. So we need to replace that before this can really go anywhere else. Like going and getting the glass put back into it. So we're gonna work on that today. Should be a pretty quick and easy project. I'm gonna show you what all is needed and how long it takes, which shouldn't hopefully be too bad. A pretty simple project. So let's go ahead and jump into it. Don't forget to leave a like on the video and check out the merch link down below as well. Let's just get into it. We got a drain pan in place now. We're gonna just put that down below. We're not gonna quite need it yet. What we're gonna do first is loosen the two bolts that actually hold the old slave cylinder to the actual transmission. And we're gonna loosen those first. Once you get the final screw out, the whole thing should just pull away, which it does. And now we can hang it down and we can untwist where it's actually connected with a 17 millimeter wrench. And this will start to cause the fluid to drain out of it. Hopefully it's not torqued onto that unbelievably tight. It's not. And we can spin this off now and then prepare yourself for fluid. So here are the two slave cylinders. Obviously the original one looks to be actual original. And you can see some of the leaking out around the front boot. So that'll be nice to get replaced. This one just feels a little bit stiffer and sturdier now anyway. So obviously they're the same. I'll leave you a link down below in the description. If you happen to look for this exact one, you can go ahead and check that out. But this should be a pretty easy swap. Now what we're gonna do is get this screwed back in here now and get it mounted back up. That'll just fall right up against that plate that actually pushes on the transmission. And it should be pretty easy. Then we just gotta bleed this thing and get the air out of it because there's a little bit in there. So let's go ahead and get this tightened back up, get the new one on the line. We'll lightly tighten it here. Doesn't need a lot. Now let's put this thing back up into place now that it's on the line. We spun them down hand tight, but now we want to make sure they are actually tight. So that's actually all mounted up there. Time to bleed it, because obviously there's air in the lines. We're going to go ahead and undo this a little bit. We'll let some of the fluid work itself down in there. And maybe in a little bit I'll get my wife out here so she can step on the clutch a few times too. So it's been a couple days. I went and I bled the system after we got the slave cylinder on, and it started to get a little bit of pressure, but then when I went to go top off the top reservoir on the master cylinder, I noticed that it is now leaking, and I'm missing a lot of paint actually in my engine bay in that area, because it has leaked in the past prior to me owning the vehicle. Now, I'm gonna guess that once the slave cylinder got put on and it was able to hold some pressure, that caused whatever, you know, weakness is happening up here to show itself again, because the pressure's better down there where it was leaking and it wasn't having the problem up top. Now it's basically switched, saying, okay, we can hold pressure down in the bottom now, but we can't hold it up top in the master. So we're gonna replace the master cylinder for the clutch, and hopefully, fingers crossed, everything should work out just fine and we shouldn't have leaks. That's the goal. Let's find out. I got my new clutch master cylinder. Nice and cheap still too. I wanna say all of these parts, if replacing both of these, less than 30 bucks for both. So pretty inexpensive. Links down below in the description if you wanna check them out, if you need these parts as well. But let's just get into it. Let's get this pulled off, back on. Hopefully we should do this quick, and everything should work when we're done.
Removal of the clutch master cylinder is not too difficult. On the inside of the cab, I removed the pin that holds the clutch master cylinder to the actual clutch pedal, and on the outside it's just two bolts and then the line that runs out of the clutch master cylinder that actually has the fluid in it. Once you loosen that up and get everything free, it does just pull away from the firewall of the pickup and comes out nice and easy. Now, from here, you're gonna wanna drain out any fluid, and inside of mine, I had a lot of dirt and it was really gross, so I can't imagine what all was maybe in these lines or what all was causing the problem, but it wasn't the best. Now, everything removed, you can see the damage from where it's been leaking out in the actual engine bay of the vehicle, but putting the new one in is obviously gonna give us a lot better result and hopefully get us some pressure in our clutch. So putting it back in is just the exact opposite of the way you took it out. Put it on the wall, get it in place, you can get the line connected back up. You'll wanna get the screws back in, obviously, on the firewall, and that holds it in place. And it's not too difficult, luckily, with basic tools. It is a little tight, I will say, on that top screw that holds it. It's just not a great angle for most wrenches and ratchets, so that's kind of annoying, unfortunately, but you can get in there, just take your time and you'll get it in there nice and secure. Then obviously move yourself into the cabin of the vehicle. You'll see where it comes down. The only thing you may need to be cautious of is it is adjustable, so you want to obviously screw down, or you rotate it and make sure that you have this lined up properly so you can get the pin back through both the clutch master cylinder and then your pedal, and then get the pin inserted back through them so obviously it doesn't come loose and you lose your clutch in a very unfortunate way. So once it's all back together, you should be good to go. Now you want to make sure that you fill your, obviously, your clutch master cylinder reservoir with some fresh fluid, and then you're gonna need to bleed the system. So there we go, we got everything nice and buttoned up. We have pressure in the clutch. I bled the system. Actually, in that last clip, if you were watching, I was actually leaning over the open or over the door with an open window and pushing down on the actual clutch pedal, and you can see little blops of air coming out. So you'll do that to get a lot of the air actually out of the master cylinder itself. Once you stop getting those little pockets of air coming out, you've got most of your actual cylinder filled with fluid, but the line will most likely still have air in it, especially the clutch or the slave cylinder underneath that we actually bled, because there's gonna be air down there too. So what I do under there to get all the air out of that is compress that down with your hand and get all of it compressed, because it's gonna force any air out of the slave cylinder. It's gonna force it back up through your line. Make sure you keep that topped off and do that a few times. Let it slowly decompress, because as it decompresses underneath, it's gonna pull the fluid back in, because the air is gonna wanna come back up to the system. So leave that cap off. Make sure you keep it topped off though, so you don't suck any more air back when it decompresses at the bottom, and you'll be able to work all the air out of the system that way. I did that, took a little bit of time, because getting all that air out does take a little bit of time. It's got a little ways to go, and you know, air sometimes can be stubborn with coming out of your actual lines. But did that, it worked nicely. We have pressure, drives great again now too. We're not grinding gears. We actually have pressure, so we're all set. We now have two of the four leaks when I bought the truck taken care of, so that's a good thing. We got our brake leak fixed, which was a problem originally. We fixed that when we did the carb install, which there's a video you can check that out on, and then we got this one fixed. Now we gotta figure out the oil leak that I know it definitely has. I believe it's oil. I don't think it's the transmission. I'm pretty sure it's the oil. And then I got another little small leak on something up front too. So nothing catastrophic, but we're gonna get those all figured out in future videos. I'm gonna have an oil change on this coming up soon with the treatment as well. So make sure you are subscribed. Drop a like on this video. Make sure the bell notifications are on. Check out the merch link down below and all the other product links if you're interested in anything that I did on this pickup truck. And I'll just see all of you guys in the next video.